Hey, don't stand, man. Great anticipation.
Hello!
Hello!
How are you doing? Are we cool?
Yeah!
Yeah. Oh, okay, she'll beat me up.
Don't watch that.
I'll fucking hell, Darren. It's not what you've got here to with these lot. It's all scary. Let's try and tell jokes. That's what we're here for. Have any of you lot, right? Have any of you seen those guys, right, with the outline beards?
Yeah.
That have, they have like an outline, right, where they might put a beard. If they like maybe later decided to grow one. Is that making fucking mind up? You know what I mean? I don't need to see what your bloody plans are. I saw a bit this other guy, right, and he had no moustache beard. Basically, he's like a beard with no moustache to hold it up. It just looks like a shape of a with his chin out, kind of jumping out and get you. I wonder, does it come alive at night? Does he put it to sleep? It's like, good night, beard. It's like, good night, master. Good night, beard. And then in the morning, it's like, come on, you're going back on my face. I don't want to go back on my face. I want to go to the post office. Like, going back on my fucking face. It's like, so I can look ridiculous again. Oh, my grandfather, my granddad, he's like the only person I know who still uses a handkerchief. Okay, it just kind of shocks and bemuses me. It's the white's acceptable. For us, the white are bogies into an ankle, a tissue. We have a little look, don't we, a little inspect. We fold it up, stick it in our pocket. We carry it around with us. We don't do this with any other bodily excretion. We don't go to the toilet, have a shit, wipe our ass, have a look, think, hey, there's a bit of space on that. Why are we trying to save the world with tissues? Who fucking cares? We're going to die anyway. It kind of reminds me, though, it reminds me of the wank sock. Yeah, you know. The guys reuse over and over again. And then when they're finished, they put it under the bed. Or in that little drawer. Or in that little drawer. It's turned into a piece of cardboard. It's giving more pain than it is for pleasure. They continue to reuse it. Now I'm thinking there's no excuse for that. There's no excuse for that shit, right? See, it's Primark. You can have a brand new white shiny sock to wank into every single time. Recently, like, it was really fucking painful and excruciating. It was horrible. I was thinking that love, right, it's like an evil jellyfish. It's like it's going along, and if you catch eyes with it, it's like bang, it's stuck to you, right? And then when they fall out of love with you, that girl or that guy, it kind of pries it off, and then you're left with this big, horrible, big gaping wound. And the only way that it's going to feel better, right, is if they come and piss on you. It fucking alkalize the wound. And he won't piss on me anymore. Bastard. Anyway, this guy, right, I fell in love with him because he was perfect. He was just fucking perfect. And he had huge feet. He had huge feet, this guy, right? And you know what they say about guys with huge feet? You know what they say? It's going to hurt when they fuck you with a foot. Penis, and you know, ladies, it's not good, is it? If I was a bloke and I had a small penis, I would just top myself. It's not like natural. We need to weed them out. We need to get them out. They shouldn't be existing. And however hard I tried to convince him to take the plunge and give in to the endless stream of junk mails about penis enlargement, he always just said he'd rather learn to live with his disability. So, you know, what do I do? He's just standing up, so I'll wrap up. It was Halloween, not long ago, like 2 months ago, it was Halloween, right? Did anyone dress up and go out for Halloween?
Yeah.
Now, do you guys know why we dress up for Halloween and go out and stuff? dress up as zombies? There's one in there. No? Okay, I'll tell you. We dress up as zombies on Halloween, right? Because on Halloween night, the zombies come out. And then if we look like zombies, then they're not going to come and attack us anymore. Okay, so I was thinking, why on Halloween night, why are there so many women dressed as prostitutes? Are all zombies in monogamous happy relationships? You know that they're not going to know anything. People who look like prostitutes aren't there. One last little thing. Have any of you heard of that phrase, chubby chasers?
Yes.
Yeah. People that fancy fat people. Now, I think it's crazy. It's a little bit strange. Right? You think about it, like how quickly are these chubby people getting away? People that fancy them are having a fucking chase. If anything, they should just be called chubby grabbers. Oh, where you gone? Oh, there you are, Ben. I've been asking you.
Not only are they crippled by their small penis, now they need to be exterminated.